Hey, I'm Mike Strauss from Mike's Barbecue. Come visit us at 1703 South 11th Street in South Philadelphia. We're at the corner of 11th and Mars. We got the smoked brisket cheesesteak, ribs, brisket, sausage, chicken. Come on down and visit us.
Banana pudding.
And we also have the banana pudding.
You'll love
Jim
it.
Loves it. Thank you.
Mike's Barbecue, South Philly. All right, Craig Levan, top 25 restaurants in Philadelphia. A couple seconds, you're going to hear the judges go on and on and on about the brisket. Mike touched on it. Yeah, brisket, ribs, all the stuff the judges and Craig Levan talk about are all good reasons to go to Mike's. But the real reason you want to go to Mike's is the banana pudding with caramel sauce. Holy mackerel. Slap my face. Oh, what a treat. You know, people talk about sign of a good chef is making a great sauce. Well, I think the sign of a great chef is ones that can make a phenomenal banana pudding with caramel sauce. Unbelievable.
Brisket's money.
This brisket's like really delicious. It's lighter. It's not real heavy. I mean, it's a substantial sandwich, but
this is like a really good brisket. You know, it's doing what it's supposed to do. It retained the moisture, but it's pulling apart when it should. That's what I think that a really good smoked brisket is supposed to do.
I mean, it's glazed. It's shiny. Like, it is. There's so much juice in there, but you can see it's cooked really, really nicely. The brisket still is nice and kind of that deep red. The crust is nice and dark and has texture on it. But I like it is. It's still the slices, and yes, it's breaking apart because it's so tender.
But like you pick it up and it like falls apart.
Yeah.
It's like.
But it's not mashed up.
Mm-mm. I didn't think that I'd like the Cooper cheese sauce. But actually, I like it. It's starting to, as time goes on, and I pushed it in a little bit. It's starting to melt in there with the onion. Yeah. You know what? This is not traditional, but I like this.
Not a traditional cheesesteak. You can see why it gets high marks.
It gives things flavor. It's fat. It gives things flavor. Crisco, fat in the can.
Hi, it's Jen from Del Rossi's Cheesesteak Company, 4th and Spring Garden. Come and have a cheesesteak, best one you're gonna have. Right in Northern Liberties. We love the neighborhood and they love us. Come on down.
Del Rossi's Cheesesteak Company, Northern Liberties, Philadelphia, PA. This is a good solid cheesesteak, and when it's not COVID, they have seating areas. I'm always surprised when I don't hear more about Del Rossi's as I'm out driving around. I don't know what else to say about it. It's a good solid cheesesteak. It's this cheesesteak that we grew up on. It's a cheesesteak that when someone says cheesesteak, it's you picture this cheesesteak. Nice solid traditional roll, Lisio's, meat's chopped nice, everything's mixed in well, and Jen is a great host. Del Rossi's, good stop.
March Cheesesteak Madness. Living the dream. Here's Del Rossi's, right over dining. There you go, there's dining in my shot of Del Rossi's. Yay! Look, here's Mark too.
Okay, let's see what we got here. Roll is a little bit soft. Very like, it's gonna break through right here. But I'm gonna let Dan talk about that because
he's a roll snob of the group.
Yeah, that is his specialty.
Yep, I see the roll. Let's see a roll.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they do hold up. You got to give them that, right?
They do. She got salt and pepper on here, though.
There's salt and pepper?
Definitely pepper on here. Ooh, a lot of pepper.
I think it's also marinated. I think like the meat itself has a lot of flavor just on its own. I think beyond just soft leather.
It's juicy.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I thought the cheese was just on top, but it's actually it's like one of those situations we had before where it kind of like mine's actually going down to the bottom.
Yeah, cheese is going throughout.
Yeah.
It's heavy. You know, it's a good amount of meat.
Uh-huh. It's a lot of meat.
Yeah. And I'm not, as they say in cheesesteak lingo, I'm not poo-pooing the roll.
No, this is just completely fine. Like it's your,
yeah.
As you said, it does hold up. I mean, it's holding it up. It's got a nice crust to it.
Yeah, when you've had some others, you start to distinguish between. But like without doing something like we're doing, you probably wouldn't pick up on it.
Yeah, I agree.
Is it toasted?
Yeah, it's definitely toasted, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The bracket is Mike's BBQ versus Del Rossi Cheesesteak Company. You wanna speak about Mike's?
Sure, Mike's BBQ. Karangi seeded roll. So being a BBQ restaurant, their specialty brisket. They did their cheesesteak with their sliced brisket. Besides the roll being great, the brisket was phenomenal. And we had a brisket cheesesteak earlier in this competition, Mike's BBQ. What differentiated the two was Mike's BBQ. They didn't grind up or chop up too much the brisket meat. They were actually just full slices of their brisket, which was awesome. It had a great exterior, nice dark crust, good texture, crispy, and then this beautiful like pink center where you know that brisket had cooked really, really slowly, nicely until it was completely tender.
You can see the ring around it.
Yeah, wonderful smoke flavor. So that was, hats off to them, that was great. They did it with a Cooper Sharp Whiz that they made in-house. Had great texture, good flavor, but because of the method that they're making the cheesesteak, the cheese was just on the top. So notable on that as opposed to being folded in, but it certainly does start to drip down being a sauce into the sandwich as you go. The onions were very sweet, small, but again, just I guess maybe the nature of a brisket sandwich and doing it the way that Mike does it, they're just kind of at the top. It's not mixed in like you would with the cheesesteak when you're chopping the meat and folding everything together. So the onions kind of got lost in the sandwich for me. Overall, incredibly juicy sandwich. Amazing flavor. I really enjoyed it.
But this one didn't have mushrooms. It just had the onions, and the onions were on the bottom. And then the brisket, of course, brisket done perfectly. And then the cheese on top, so it kind of did blend together very well, I think. And it's in competition with Del Rossi cheesesteak. Del Rossi has Alessio's roll, it wasn't seeded. It held up really well with the cheesesteak. It was almost as if they marinated their meat. It was so flavorful.
They said they didn't.
Yeah,
it was delicious.
Yeah. Jen, the owner, was there. She said, no, they don't marinate it, but they do cook it on the flat top, and their ribeye, they just add salt and pepper to taste, and it was, that was great. The American was on top, but it fell through as you were eating the cheesesteak, which was nice. The mushrooms and onions, small bites, salt and pepper. Seasoned well. This one's really tough because honestly, I have both of them scored with the exact same score. So to me, I could go either way because they both have the exact same score. I'm gonna have to say though, I'm probably gonna choose Jen and Del Rossi just because it is more of a traditional cheesesteak. And it just eats so well, and it just held up really nice, and it was actually like one of my favorite sandwiches.
I agree with you. A cheesesteak competition, it's hard for me to give a brisket sandwich the nod, even though it was an incredible sandwich. My vote goes to Del Rossi.
Incredible brisket.
Absolutely recommend both places. And if you go to Mike's Barbecue, we enjoyed the banana pudding, and I highly recommend you too.
The banana pudding. I don't even like bananas.
Thanks, Mike. Yes.
Yeah, so I'm going to say Del Rossi's.